So that's what this is about.
Yeah.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to my channel, Herpticulture, and I'm Ronald Damp. Today, we're getting ready to set off to go to the Reptiles Zoo and Gardens in Palm Springs. I'm really excited about this. I've been looking at their website, and they have a lot to offer. And I think you guys, if you're interested and if you're in the area, check their website out. It's livingdesert.org, events and tours. They have everything on there that's coming up. They have behind-the-scenes tours. They have feeding the giraffes, safari tours. And then they have special events on a calendar that are set in place for the near future. So today I'm just going to go check it out. It's my first time there. I'm going to take you guys along with me, and I'm pretty excited about it. So hopefully it's not windy. The forecast said something about a little bit of wind, but I don't see no, I'm looking out my window now, I don't see any wind yet, but it's still early. I wanted to also mention Friday, March 8th, they're going to have a special speaker, Dr. Christopher Tracy and Philip L. Boyd from the Deep Canyon Desert Research Center at the University of California, Riverside. They are going to do a speech on the similarities and differences in ecology of the Coachella fringe toed lizard and the desert plated lizard of Namibia, which I'm pretty excited about. It's, I'm looking at my calendar, March 8th, 12 to 1 p.m. So it's just an hour's time where they're going to be doing a speech. So you get into the zoo, you pay your thing, and then you can go to the reptile center or wherever it's located at. I don't know yet. And says, anyways, you guys can read it for yourself. It's on the calendars of events. And go see what they have to say about these animals. That's on my calendar for sure. You guys will definitely be seeing me there. All right, guys, you guys know what to do. Hit that subscribe button. Hit that like button if you're liking what you're seeing. And hit that bell so you guys know when I upload videos, which is every Friday. Let's get moving, guys. The doors open at 9, and it's almost 9 already. It's going to take about 45 minutes probably to get there. So let's go have a good day.
Free from living lies. Free from my own deception. Headed the right direction. I walked through the fields of mud. I thought I'd find a shelter in you, a perfect sky. Doors open, doors close, and my heart again. Wonder how long it'll take till I kill the pain.
Okay, I'm on the freeway on the I-10 East, heading towards Palm Springs, and it's raining. There's like water falling on my windshield, but there's not a cloud over me. I don't understand what's going on here.
You have arrived at your destination. Your route guidance is now finished.
Okay, everybody, we made it in. We are in the Living Desert Zoo and Gardens from what I see so far. It's pretty beautiful in here. Everything's clean, lots of trees, and I can hear lots of animals and birds and whatnot. So I have the schedule here, the itinerary. It says 10 o'clock cheetah chat. I think it's a little past 10 o'clock, but so I'm gonna head over there to the cheetah exhibit and see what that's all about. It'll be our first attraction for the day, and then we'll work through the rest. Let's go see.
Thank you.
So that was a cheating exhibit. They were supposed to have some kind of a presentation there, a speaker that was supposed to be doing something with the cheetahs, but I guess they weren't cooperating, and I guess the show was over. So, but I was able to I was lucky enough to be able to get some footage of them cruising by the window there. They're kind of just running around there and, you know, pacing back and forth in their enclosure. Kind of, they were just released, I guess. So, from their pens, feeding time, I assume is what they're doing. So I don't know. We're going to the next. I gotta look at the itinerary here. I think it's gonna be zebra talk. The zebra, the zebra sanctuary here at the next location here. So we're gonna see what this is all about. So is that like a sausage tree? Is that like where vegan sausages come from? Just kidding. So we're at the slender horned gazelle exhibit. And we're gonna take a look at this exhibit. It's pretty cool. As you can see behind me, this zoo is built right in the middle of the desert here in Palm Springs. And it's really cool because it provides a really cool habitat similar to where a lot of these species and animals come from. So it works out really well here. Okay, it is 10:45. I have 15 minutes until the next show, or whatever you want to call it. It's called Zebra Chat, and we're at the zebra habitat here, 11 a.m. I missed the cheetah chat because I guess the cheetahs weren't cooperating and I was a few minutes late. So we're gonna hit this one. I don't want to miss to see what they're gonna do. And then after that, there's supposed to be a Eagle Canyon chat, 11:45. And then I will probably do a little exploring myself, get lunch, and then at 2:45, giraffe chat, and 3 p.m. reptile show, which I'm not gonna miss, you know that. You better believe it. All right, so we're hanging out. Stay tuned.
Oh, so that's what this is about.
Yeah. It's making... Oh my. Okay, I've never seen a zebra mate before.
So interesting note here, zebra stripes. They serve the same function as a striping or a pattern on a snake in the wild. What it does is when the animals are moving and they're evading predators, it kind of throws off the vision from the predator. The predators can't really see the animal that well when they're moving due to the striping and the patterns. Blurs their vision a little bit, almost blurs of where the animal's going. I know some firsthand experience chasing a desert pachinko snake, and he was striped and moving quickly, and it was hard for me to keep my eyes and track him in the shrubbery. So, good stuff. Just kind of an interesting note there.
That does not look pleasant. That looks like that would really hurt if you fell into it.
All right, I had to spend some time at the meerkat enclosure there. Meerkats are just, they're the cutest little buggers, man. They're just, you know, they're remind me of, I used to have pet ferrets, and they kind of remind me of that. So I had to get some good still photos of them. They gave me, I was able to get some good couple close-ups. So, you know, while I'm touring the zoo here, I'm also posting to Instagram too. So guys, check out my Instagram channel. I'll be posting pictures of, trying to get as many animals as possible and film at the same time. So, all right, onward. I think it's almost time for our eagle exhibit or wild dog exhibit. Still haven't determined yet what I'm gonna do, but they're both at the same time. So let's go see.
Target. Good. Station. So this is the station behavior, where she keeps her two front paws on that log until she hears a bridge, which are the magic words, good. And then she gets down. Up. Good. And that up behavior allows us to take a really good look on her underbelly. There we go. And then down. Good. This is our target behavior. So it's just a buoy on a stick, and her criteria is to boop her nose to it. It's helpful for us as keepers because then we can move our dogs anywhere we really want to. Target. Target. Let's try it over here. Target. Good. Yep. So Eskimo dogs, they don't really bark or howl like a normal dog would. They actually communicate through a lot of yips and yaps. So I'm working with Beatrix right now, getting that vocalization on a cue. So we'll see. Yep. Good. She's very talkative, so it's hard to ask her things when she's talking. Yep. Yep. Good. Yep. Good. Station. So when she goes on the station behavior, if you guys want to take a look on the inside of her two front legs, she actually lacks a dew claw, so that's typical of all African wild dogs, and it's one of the physical characteristics that sets them apart from domesticated dogs. Good.
So how cool is that, guys? African wild dogs. Man, seeing those dogs up close like that, and the, just the power of their jaws and their wildness, not like a regular domestic dog, that's for sure. Just, they're beautiful, though. African wild dogs, man, they're survivors, and if you've watched any programs on them before, they're pretty amazing animals. So that was cool. The presentation's still going on, but I'm gonna keep moving because I have a lot to see still, and I'm getting hungry, so. I gotta make sure I'm ready for that 3 o'clock event, Reptiles. Pretty excited about that. I'm over here, as I'm sitting here at these tables, look at all these different aloe vera plants. There's a lot of different kinds. And that's just some of them. There's more. So just like us herpetoculturists, we enjoy viewing and studying different subspecies of species and different subspecies of reptiles and amphibians. you horticulturists out there, you know, have the same thing, I guess. You know, I don't know. I've never really been into plants before, but I guess it's the same thing, right? So, pretty cool place. All right, guys, I'm going to go get some food, I think. I'll see you in a bit. So, this is the bighorn sheep enclosure. But there's two keepers up in the mountains there. They're peering off into the sky. And everyone's kind of wondering what was going on. Well, as one of the private safari carts were driving by this, there was a code blue, which means there's an animal escape. So I'm assuming it's a falcon or an eagle that flew off and never came back. That's my assumption. So kind of hard to catch a bird unless it's trained, right? All right, so that's probably what's going on here. That kind of sucks. All right, onward. All right, guys, I'm gonna go through this really quickly. I just experienced that my other battery was dead on my camera, and I went to change my battery out, and it's dead, so I have very little record time. So I'm gonna hit the reptile house right now, show you guys real quickly, and whatever I don't capture, look for pictures on my Instagram. Here we go. This is an interesting reptile house, if I've ever seen one. Everybody, all right, I'm back from the zoo. Well, as you guys know, my other battery wasn't charged, or I'm telling you now that it wasn't charged. If you guys follow me on Facebook, on Instagram, you would see that I put a little quick little video in there of the news about my other battery dying. So basically what happened was I went to lunch, and I noticed that my first battery was almost dead, so I went to change it out, and lo and behold, the other battery was also dead. I didn't double check. I didn't check my gear before I left. I assumed that the other battery was charged, which you should never do. You should never assume anything. Always check and double check your gear before you go on an adventure or on a trip or whatever for your, you know, for your camera gear. Anyways, it was towards the end of the
towards the end of the day anyways, the reptile room was pretty cool. Decorated pretty interesting. You know, each vivarium was pretty interesting. Kind of decorated with a lot of art deco kind of stuff. You know, being in Palm Desert, I kind of expect that. But cool trip. I'm going back because I'm going to finish what I started. I'm going to do like kind of like a part two of the trip. There's a lot of things I didn't get to see, like giraffes, and it's a big park. It was pretty cool. So I hope you guys enjoyed the first part of this. I am going to go back again. I'm going to meet the zookeeper for the reptile display, see what they have to say, see what kind of presentation they give, talk to them a little bit, ask them questions, have charged batteries, refilm the whole reptile area, and probably incorporate something else into it for that day also. So look forward. I don't know when that's going to be. Maybe not the video after this, but maybe a couple ahead of this one. I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do it yet, but I'm going to go back. So anyways, guys, thanks so much for watching this video. Hope you guys enjoy it. Thanks for all my subscribers. Thanks for all my new subscribers. Thank you for the support. I really, really appreciate it. You guys have an awesome day. And remember, make the day count and have fun doing it. See you next time.